I've done
negotiation.
Charlie, I've done a lot of arms control with the Soviet Union. And I'm and as an intelligence officer, an intelligence advisor to the negotiating team, I had some responsibilities when it came to the verification regime and how we could monitor compliance. Those agreements were very simple and mainly relied on our own satellites. We still found anomalies and we still found evidence that we thought Soviets were in violation of those agreements. This agreement is much more complex, requires access, direct access to many places to ensure that they're not cheating. So this verification regime is really important, and the devil is in the details. And my concern is that we'll find evidence of an ambiguous compliance, and we'll have a big interagency debate about it here in the United States about whether the information is valid or not. The State Department and the White House will be arguing it's not valid. The intelligence community will be saying, here's the evidence that we have. And we'll be wrapped around the axle, and we won't know for sure. So that's why the details of this verification are so important.
Most of the debates within government between state and CIA and defense, or is that just one example you used?
That's just one example. I mean, particularly on arms control, those who have negotiated the arms control agreements don't like to have the intelligence guys saying, you know, the other side may not be complying.
Do you believe, A, the president seems to be, based on all that he has, and he's shown he's prepared to use force in different ways, that the president is of a mindset that this is so important that it's worth taking the risk, A, or do you believe that the president simply wants this too much? And there's a real danger for us because...
I think anybody who has ever engaged in a negotiation knows that to be successful, you have to be willing to walk away from the table. And I worry that the agreement has taken on such importance that even if these ambiguities and questions are unanswered, there will be a great reluctance to walk away. Even if your intent is simply to come back to the negotiations and try and get a better deal.
So you think the president may want it too much?
Let me just say, I hope not.
But you're worried.
I'm worried.